I got a package yesterday. Only I didn't know that I had a package yesterday. The mail people and the UPS people, when they come to our house and they want to deliver stuff, a lot of times they just put it in the garage and you don't even know that it's there. And they come at all different times, so they must have come at a time that, you know, we had already gone to get our mail and had no need to go back out to the garage, except later yesterday, I guess when Adam was taking the garbage out, he saw this box. And it was laying down here this morning when I got up. So my friend Melissa made this, and she told me she was sending this to me. She said, I think you'll like it. And I can already tell through the bubble wrap, I'm going to like it because I see it's an owl. Can you see it? At least I think it's an owl. But she made this because she's been doing all kinds of ceramic stuff. At least I think she told me she made it. I believe she did. So, let's see if I can get this opened. Very nice. Oh, and it's one of these, look, it's one of these little potpourri candle holders. That is too adorable. So cute. And yes, I love it because I'm really into owls. Of course, like I keep saying, I'm into all kinds of birds because I love birds. I've always liked birds and the different variety of birds. And you see from like my last video that I put out, I showed you my hummingbirds. I love those too. I don't know if there was something. I thought she said there was two things in here. Let's have a feel and check. Maybe it's just the one thing. Wait. Yep, there's something at the bottom. See? Look at that. I would have missed it. Oh, and very nice. I like baskets. Oh, and I can tell this is homemade too. Look at that. With the little button thingies. How sweet. I really like that. By Missy. Yep, she made that too. Thanks, Melissa. Thank you, Melissa. I am so pleased and so happy that you sent that to me. How nice. So, I'll have to get one of my votive candles burning in this thing here really soon. And I think that's it. I think you only said there was two things, but I'm going to feel down here just to make sure. Okay, I don't feel nothing, but that's a nice box and a lot of peanuts and bubble wrap. I'm going to save that for when I've got to send something out. So thanks. I love it. I love it. It looks so nice. And let's see. I got all my owls over there in my family room. I'm going to try to find a nice little spot here in my kitchen where I can put it. Maybe I'll move that thing somewhere and I can put my owl up there. That way when I have this little tree thing lit up, the owl can be lit up next to it. I think that's what I will do. And I forgot to show you guys. I showed it in the pictures, but I forgot to tell you when I was getting all my different things from Michael's and the Christmas tree shop, there was this chicken. And it's got the holes and everything in it too, but it's not a candle, unfortunately, or four candles. But I got that over at Michael's as well. So I got that next to that chicken. So yeah, I'm going to move my little vase and put my owl over there. And I'll have to get a candle later when it gets dark out and light that. And it's just a cleaning day for me today. Tomorrow, I have to take my daughter-in-law to the doctor's. She's got to go for the home stretch now. She will see, let's see, she saw the doctor 2 weeks ago, so she sees him tomorrow, and then every week now, I think, is what the doctor said she'll have to go for her weekly visits. Unless he skips another 2 weeks, and then those last few weeks she goes every single time. I got Lucy that wants to go out just a minute. Anyway, so when I go over there tomorrow to pick her up, we had helped them start hanging the curtains up, and so we saw them in the living room and Alex's room, but we didn't see them in their bedroom, so I want to see how that turned out. My son got the bassinet put together. I don't know if he's got the crib or anything else put together, but he better step on it. But whatever and all that he's got put together furniture-wise, I want to take a peek and see how that all turned out. And I think tomorrow I'll go over to the Amish farm stand, provided that it's not raining tomorrow, and get some more potatoes and other yummy garden veggies. I don't know if I'll take my daughter-in-law with me or not on that. We'll have to see. Look at Lucy, how pitiful she's looking at me. She's saying, stop rambling. Put me out. I do have to go outside because I have gas cans. I cut the grass a couple days ago and I left these gas cans out because I have to fill them up with gas and then get these back in the shed. That's another errand I guess I will do tomorrow. So take these into the garage. Oh, look at the kitty. Yes, you're being a good boy. I'm showing my owl that Melissa gave me. I had it over there and I put my little vase thing back because you know, I got this little lighted thing there. So I decided instead of using it to put a candle in it. Listen how loud these dogs are. Really, Lucy? Do you have to be that loud? But anyway, I just put one of those little nightlight things in it. I got the cord in through there and just laid it down there. So anyway, just more nightlight for night. My little lights up there with my butterflies. What are they? Fireflies. And all my lights over there, and my lights over there, and my light there, and my candles there, and my lights over there. So anyway, I think I'm going to do a new one of these, but I'm going to put it over here. I'll probably take all those pictures down. I'm gonna, when I get more fall things, and I'm gonna make one of those garlands to go here, plug it in, and move my pictures and just put a bunch of fall things in there. Binks, do you want to go outside? And one of my, oh, it came on today. I was gonna say, one of my solar lights, this first one right here, it wasn't working for the last couple days. And it came on today. That's nice. It's supposed to rain tonight. Thunderstorms. So I'm glad I cut the grass today. And I can't lock my door. Rain all day tomorrow, too. Enjoy the rain, Mr. Binks. Hi, dear Lucy. I'm doing laundry today. And I hope that that dries before it rains. It's getting very cloudy. There's still some blue skies over there. It's real cloudy over there. I just got done cutting Adam's hair. He's getting me the broom. But here's my crepe myrtles. Remember I told you again how it would canopy over, and the more that these start to bloom out, it gets really heavy. So you can see these are already done. And all the petals and everything, they go away and fall down. So anyway, but yeah, here's our nice canopy of branches. And now I have to trim these because this is in the walkway. This is scratching me, and so is that one. And I have a couple other branches that I need to go cut. I'm going to have Adam, don't leave. I need to have Adam saw off for me because I'm tired of hitting it when I'm going outside to mow the lawn. And though Carly and I have trimmed all of this, look at how it's all bushy again. I need to trim this stuff up too. And those branches hanging down there, I need to cut back. I need to snip a little bit more over there. when you have a lot of landscaping, it's just the constant battle of things. I know, look at you, Chloe, you're getting hit with that. Oh, and my one neighbor's tree over this one right there. You see how the beetles ate almost all the leaves off of that? And my plum trees are really bad too. This one and this other one next to it aren't too bad. It's just at the top. But I gotta show you. See, they ate all the leaves off of there, those sticks hanging there. But when you come around here, see, it gets real scarce looking. And look at that tree. They ate almost all the leaves off of that. And look at this one. Those nasty beetles. They ate almost all the leaves off. Unbelievable. And over there, but my neighbor's tree is the same. Adam, come on. And I got a vine growing through there. See those white flowers? I gotta find out where that's coming from, and I gotta pull it out. I'm doing some cleaning, a lot of cleaning up in my bedroom and throwing stuff out. And I came upon this picture with some other ones that we had tucked away. Adam was actually cleaning out his closet. There was a moving box that we hadn't opened yet, so it's been in there for almost 7 years. And this is Stephen Ho. He was in the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, the first Ninja Turtle movies that came out. There's a new one now. But anyway, he played Donatello. And my son used to take karate. And so he came to the karate studio because Stephen Ho was friends with Tom Wind. And Tom Wind was my son's, actually sons, meaning Adam too, because they both took karate. But he was, Stephen Ho was friends with Tom Wind. They knew each other and had known each other from competitions and that. And Tom Wind also knew, what's his name? The crow guy, Brandon Lee. Bruce Lee's son, and he was really good friends with him. Matter of fact, he was actually even at his funeral when he died. So anyway, the girlies have my bed all a mess because they've been getting up and down off of the bed, and I've scrubbed down all my furniture. I don't want to say scrubbed down, but wiped everything down really, really good, so everything's all shiny again. And somebody lost their bandana. And these, I had just washed these. These go on the nightstands and over there. Whoops. And I put bandanas on the girlies. I used to do this when I had my other boxers, Noah and Aslan. And I've only done it with them a few times because they take them off. So anyway, now I've got to get these things back up for the girlies, get them all wrinkled. Get off of there, Lou. Loose. Get off. Look, your foot's stuck. And here's another keychain. Ah, so I'll show you what I did. this used to have a bunch of our owner's manuals for things, and I cleared all of this stuff out a little while ago, but I had still some old, like, you know, summer pajamas and stuff that I never wore, and I mean, I haven't worn them for years. I don't know why I was saving them, but I threw those out. This is actually Harry's nightstand because he sleeps this side of the bed, but this is all his junk. I have no idea what all that stuff is, but I condensed everything to this smaller drawer, and now that one is empty in case we need it. Right, Lucy? And then over here, oh, look at that. I cleared all of that off. I'll probably, you know, start finding some new knick-knack things to put up there. But I'm going to wait until, like, after the holidays because, you know, it's fall now. I might, you know, pick up some fall things to put there. But then it'll be Christmas before we know it. Well, Christmas season for me, you know, starts November 1st. And so usually I have a lot of Christmas things up there anyway. So, yeah, I'm just going to wait till after the new year and then do something. I've been actually even thinking about repainting the room This is like, of course, this shows up orange every single time that I upload video footage from in here in my room, but this is a gold color, and I like it, but I'm almost wondering if I want to go lighter and repaint this room. I don't know. It's been like this for, I think, 5 years now. It's been like this. So anyhow, these drawers are pretty basically all cleared out, but this drawer is my summer pajamas in here, and it was getting so congested, just keeping everything. I was smashing everything in there. Like I had a set of, you know, pajamas here, and then here, when I was putting like the summer, let me just show you, let me pull, like these are shorts, okay, but like this here, see, this is a set, this is a top with the shorts, you know, and so by the time that I had them just folded, you know, in half, like so, well, that's not half, but anyway, but have them in half, and in here, I was starting to run out of room, because I bought a few new summer pajamas this year, and it's like I was keeping stuff over there. So what I decided to do to make my life a lot easier was I just rolled everything. Just kept everything together like that, rolled it, and then just tuck it in there. And so, and this is just one pair of pajama shorts. Like I just get like a tank top or something I wear with it, but these are all like sets. And then these are the, these are actually like sweatpants, but I use them for pajamas, but they're the cropped ones that come like past your knee a little bit. So these are like for the fall, this one too. And then these are the cropped ones too. Those are, but I've actually been wearing these on the cooler nights. And then this is my one and only nightgown. I'm not a nightgown person per se. I would rather have either, you know, the long pants in the winter with the shirt, and then the shorts with the shirt in the summer. So this year I decided to buy a nightgown, because I haven't had a nightgown in many years, because I don't like nightgowns. I don't like them, and I'll tell you why. Because when you go to sleep at night and you're turning, and I toss and I turn a lot, it all gets all swirled around you and tangled up, and forget it. Sometimes you get out of bed, you know, in your pajamas practically, or, you know, up to your neck. Everything just kind of like creeps up on you and stuff, so I don't like them. And I'm all sweaty right now and dirty, actually, from dust and everything and just cleaning. I cleaned really, really good in here. The girlies' beds are over there. I got to fix that, but that's about it. Oh, and then this one, this felt. I got to put this back over on my nightstand. And I did the same thing. I condensed my few things to here. And in here, just a couple manuals for like the television and that. And I found a couple more pictures. Want to see them? These things are really, really old. I'll show them to you. We had these taken, oh, I don't even know. I can't remember when. Let's see, Brian was, I think, 2, almost 3 there. And this is like really dusty. It's been packed away, but yeah, he was about 2 to 3, and Adam was, I think, 4 here, and so yeah, that's us, and Joe, and Carly, and then this one, whoops, this was with my brothers, me, and my parents, and look at the mullet thing, so let's see, what year was that? Brian was born in 92, so 94. So, yeah, that was about 1994. So, that's my brother Michael. He's my youngest brother, me, my brother David, and my mom and my dad. All right, so that's all. That's all nice and tidy now. And I always keep a flashlight by my bed, because the power goes out from time to time. See, this is why my bed is a mess, because them just being all over the bed. And yesterday, the girlies had a bath. Adam was off yesterday, so he helped me give them a bath. And I've straightened up my closet I don't know how many times. And I was in here even kind of straightening things up again. These are those socks. You know how they give them to you in the hospital? Harry had these when he had his knee surgery, and he was going to throw them out. And I'm like, forget it. I like these things because they have the no skid stuff on it. So I actually like to wear those, like in the winter. So that's a pair of winter pajama pants that actually need to go up here. But I'm not going to pull all that down. And this is a pair of pants that I noticed had a little thing that needs to be sewn. Just a little tiny thing. So I'll have to do that. Not today. My Furbies, I put them up here. I'm tired of seeing those things out. And so, and then my beach bags up here. I don't know. They keep falling out. So anyway, that's about as good as my closet's going to be for now. So, what else did I do? And then I was in here, and I was straightening out the office and dusting everything. Everything's all nice and tidy, and my husband does this. I don't know why. He says, so I can see outside. And he says when, like, the window's open, he goes, so the breeze blows in. But these are such light, sheer curtains that when the wind blows, you know, it blows them out here anyway, and it's, like, see-through anyhow. So, it's like, wind filters through there. And then he says, well, I want to see outside. Okay, I can see outside. I see my neighbor's house, but he wants to see it like that. But I don't know. I like shears because I like my privacy. So anyway, so I have my office all tidy and clean. That's what I've been doing. Sleeping girlies. And now I'm a mess and it's time for me to go in there and get myself all washed up, and I need to go find myself some pajamas. What will I put on now? I don't know. Oh, and you know something? I went and I got this. I've been meaning to tell you guys this, but my camera's always downstairs. But this is that physician's formula, and it's called the Natural Nude. And these colors are so, so nice. This is what I've been wearing for the last almost month now since I've gotten that. I really like that. And I wanted to tell you guys about that. I've been meaning to tell you guys about that for the longest time. I think there was one other thing I was going to tell you, and I had no idea. But you know what's really funny? Oh, Chloe was looking at me. Look at her. Look at her ear. She is so funny. Oh, funny. So, anyway, what I was going to say to you guys, you know what I'm loving? I love it when I look out my windows, no matter what window I'm looking at in my house, at 8:30 at night, it's dark. I'm so glad that it's starting to get dark earlier. I've mentioned so many times, numerous times, that I am not a summer person and I am not a daylight savings time person. I don't like when it's light at 9 o'clock and 9:15 at night. I like it dark then. And so now, 8:30, it's like dark. So I'm really happy. And one other thing I was going to tell you. What was it? It was that and one other thing. Now I can't remember. So, I don't know. Oh, and then one other picture I found. I found this one. This is when we moved to Chicago. We had our house built. This was our first Christmas. Yeah, this was our, no, this was our second Christmas. The first Christmas we were living in an apartment, waiting for this house to be built. We moved in January 1st of 1997. So this was 1997, Christmas then. So it was our second Christmas. But that was like the picture that we had taken to put in our Christmas cards. And that was our first boxer that we ever got. Her name was Noah. She was so cute. We miss her. She was so, so good. She was a good dog. All my dogs are always good. There was one other thing I was going to tell you guys. What was it? Oh, I'm going Christmas shopping tomorrow. That's not what I was going to tell you, but I'm going Christmas shopping tomorrow. And we're going to make a nice day of it. We were going to go today. And my son Adam had to work. They changed his schedule, so he's off tomorrow. So he's going to go, and my daughter's going, and her boyfriend's going. And hopefully I'm going to get all my Christmas shopping done tomorrow. And I'm going to start looking out for some fall things, too, because we're going to Lancaster. And there's a whole bunch of different shops out there. So I'm going to do that. That still wasn't what I was going to tell you. I can't remember what I was going to tell you. I'm going to try to remember to take my camera. And you guys can tag along with us and while we go do our shopping and so forth. So anyway, that's my next destination. I got to get all this sweat washed off of me. So I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye.